reviewing the computations. After you have ran a design or analysis scenario, you can always go back in and review your computation that you have done. So one way you can do it is go back to the Compute Center. And in here, if you go to the calculation summary, you can always go back in here and select details, and this will give you the details and a summary of each one of your catchments, your links, your nodes, your inlets. Kind of gives you a summary of each one of those. And you can kind of review those as needed and then modify your design if you need to for your drainage that you're doing for this project. If I close those down, and I will close this tool, there's another set of tools that you can look at also, which are set up in some flex tables, which is this little icon right here. So if I select it, and I go to the Hydraulic Analysis tab, underneath Tables Shared, we have created some reports that you can look at for your network that you have ran. So if we double-click on one of these, let's say the MoDOT base report, this will give you a base report of your drainage network that you have done. Kind of just gives you some general information about it. And you can look at these tables as needed for your project just by simply double left-clicking on it, and it brings up that report. And you can review each one of those as needed and then modify your design. So those are some of the tables that are set up by default. Now another thing worth noting inside of the flex tables are you can actually come in here and edit some certain things in the flex tables, and it will reflect back to your drainage design. So for an example of that, let's go to the MoDOT Catch Basin Report. And inside of here, anything that is in white, you can actually edit those numbers and it would reflect in your actual drainage design. So let's say this elevation invert right now for this sag inlet, it is set to 769.41. Maybe I want that to be a little bit deeper. So I'm going to come through here and swipe through that and type in 768.00. I'll tab to lock it in. It actually locks that elevation. So now if I close out of it, and I actually come through here and select that particular node, and I go to the properties of it, you'll see that it's basically 768, which there is some rounding with that. But then also if we come in here and we select that node again, and I go to my utility properties, you will see inside here, if you scroll down through there, you'll see that the elevation invert is set to 768 now. So if you wish to do that, you can actually come into your flex tables and edit those numbers, and it will reflect in your actual drainage design. That's another way you can modify your elevations or modify certain things with your drainage network, if you wish to do that. So that's the basics of reviewing your computations that you have. You can either go to the flex tables, like what we just had, or you can go to calculation summary and go to details and find the summary of those.